text talks about the conversion of heat into work and work into heat. In thermodynamics, we are considering a system. What is a system? A system is a group of particles. Maybe it is a group of atoms or a group of molecules. In order to describe a system, we require some variables which are called as thermodynamical variables. So there are two types of thermodynamical variables. One is called as extensive variable, another one is called as intensive variable. So what is an extensive variable? So let me explain using an example. Mass and volume are the example for extensive variable. Suppose I have 1 kilogram of mass on my right hand, as well as 1 kilogram mass at my left hand. On being added up, what I have is the resulting system of 2 kilogram of mass. So those gases, those variable that satisfies the above algebraic additions are called as extensive variable. Those variable that do not satisfy the above algebraic addition are called intensive variable. For example, temperature, pressure, they do not satisfy the above algebraic addition. For example, I have a beaker possess some amount of hot water at 30 degrees Celsius. And in my left hand also, there is some amount of water, equal amount of water at 20 degrees Celsius. Let me combine them to a resulting system. The resulting system does not expect to have the 50 degrees Celsius. Therefore, the variable is what is called as intensive variable. Now, as to describe the state of a system, after some time, what would be the state of the system after some time? We have what is called as equation of state. What is an equation of a state? An equation of a state is a relation connecting these thermodynamical variables. So there are two types of equations of state. One is called as van der Waals equation of state, another one is called as ideal gas equation. Van der Waals equation of state is meant for real gas. A gas under room temperature and normal density can act as a real gas, while the gas under room temperature and low density has been idealized as an ideal gas. In order to talk about the ideal gas, we have an equation of state that is what is called as ideal gas equation. So ideal gas equation, everyone knows about it. It is PV equal to mu into R into T, where P is called as the pressure of the gas, V is called as the volume, mu is called as the number of moles, R is called as the gas constant, and T is called as the temperature. Now, as to make use of this equation of state to a system, we need the system to be a condition, to be under a condition that is what is called as thermodynamical equilibrium. What is meant by thermodynamical equilibrium? Suppose a system is being described by some variables. Suppose the variables do not change with respect to time, that is pressure, volume, temperature. If they do not change with respect to time, then the system is under thermodynamical equilibrium. So if a system is under thermal equilibrium with the surrounding, the system as well as the surrounding will be in the same temperature. So temperature is a concept that has been brought by a law, that is what is called as zeroth law of thermodynamics. Now let us come back to heat and work. What is heat? The energy in transit is what is called as heat. So whenever some amount of heat is provided to a system, so in thermodynamics probably, most probably we are considering gas as a system. So as I apply a particular amount of heat to the system, unless the volume of the system is remained constant, so there definitely there will be some amount of work. This amount of work then is given by W equal to integral of P into dV. dV is the change in volume. So whenever there is a change in volume associated with the system, there will be, we can say, some amount of work will be done. So it's a very important formula as to solve problems. As a matter of illustration, here I have given a particular number of moles, mu number of moles are there. So I want to brought down from my initial temperature T to final temperature 4T. So pressure has been fixed in terms of temperature as P equal to A by T. So I want to find out the amount of work done. It's a very important problem. So everyone knows this, the amount of work done is given by W equal to integral of P into dV. In these type of problem, the simple logic is you have to change the change of volume into change of temperature. That's all. It's a very simple logic. For this, when we handle with this equation of state, V equal to mu into RT by P. So pressure is given by P equal to A by D. Let me make a substitution. What I get is V equal to mu into R into T square by A. So the problem is very simple. We have to change this dV into dT. That's all. Once you differentiate this, dV equal to 2 into mu into R into T into dT by A. So in the place of dV, I can substitute this expression. So the limit of integration varies from T to 4T. Once I cancel this A and T, so by taking the constants outside, the only variable is temperature. So if that temperature varies from T to 4T, after making this integration, what I get is W equal to 6 into mu into R into T. This is my answer for the amount of water. Whenever new number of moles have been transferred from a temperature of T to 4T, while the pressure has been kept constant as P equal to A by D. So the amount of heat that has been supplied to the system not only increases the work, but also it produces what is called as a change in internal energy. So we have to talk about what is internal energy. So let us see what is internal energy. So a gas is supposed to have many number of molecules. What exists between these molecules is an intermolecular attraction. This intermolecular attraction leads to what is called as potential energy for the gas. On the other hand, while we are supplying heat energy to the gas, it provides kinetic energy to the gas molecules. As a result, the gas is said to have an internal energy, which is a summation of kinetic energy plus potential energy. But this holds only for real gas. So in the case of ideal gas, what we are assuming is the intermolecular attraction is negligible. Therefore, ideal gas possesses an internal energy only contributed from this kinetic energy of the molecules. So as per this kinetic theory of gases, people know this kinetic energy of a molecule of a gas that depend upon temperature. Therefore, we can write mu is proportional to temperature. It's a very important thing. This internal energy is a function of temperature. Moreover, this internal energy is a state function. What is a state function? If a function depend upon the initial and the final point of its travel, then it is what is called a state function. On the other hand, if it depends upon the amount of work done along a given path, then it is a path function. So as we explain this state function, let me make an illustration. Before that, with the first law that brought about the concept of this internal energy, it has stated the amount, the three variables, that is the heat energy, work done, and the internal energy. These three variables have been related by a formula Q equal to delta U plus W. As a matter of illustration, for internal energy as a state function, let me consider an example. A system of gas has been taken from an initial state to the final state through two paths. One is IAF, another one is IPF. So let us assume that Q1 is the amount of heat provided to the system while it has been taken from IAF, and W1 is the amount of work done while it is being taken from IAF. So using this first law of thermodynamics, I can find out how much is the change in internal energy as the system traverses from I to F. Let us come to the second case, IPF. Here, the amount of heat energy supplied has to take the system from initial state to final state is 36 calories. I want to find out how much is the amount of work done. Here, we are making use of the concept of internal energy as a state function. So the change in internal remains the same. Therefore, the change in internal energy we have found using the path IAF can be used here, and we can find out the amount of work done as 36 minus 30. Here 30 is the change in internal energy in the first part. So we can make use here because internal energy is a state function, and I can easily find out the amount of work as 6 calorie. Next, let us go for this law of equipartition of energy. Law of equipartition of energy says that each and every degrees of freedom make a contribution of half into RT for one mole of a given gas. So the general formula is U equal to F into R, half into R into T, where is the number of degrees of freedom. If it is a monoatomic gas, the internal energy is written as 3 by 2 R into T, because monoatomic is said to have 3 degrees of freedom. In the case of diatomic gas,
he possesses 5 degrees of freedom. Therefore, I can write u diatomic is 5 by 2 into r into t. So again, I stress this internal energy is a function of temperature. Let me make the variation of this internal energy with respect to temperature. I get a new quantity, that is what is called as specific capacity at constant volume. So here u equal to f into 1 by 2 into r into t. Differentiation of this will give f by 2 into r. It's a very important formula. Now I want to discuss how to determine the specific capacity at constant volume. So let me provide the two molecules of monoatomic gas and two molecules of diatomic gas. I want to find out how much is the molar specific capacity at constant volume. I want to find out the CV. So for this, I must find out this weighted average. CV equal to mu 1 CV 1 plus mu 2 CV 2 by mu 1 plus V 2. You might have known about this. This is what is called as, this quantity is what is called as the weighted average of the specific capacity. So first two molecules, so I have placed 2. Here the specific capacity of this monoatomic gas is 3 by 2 into R. So likewise, 2 moles of diatomic gas is given. Its specific capacity at constant volume is 5 by 2 into R. Both are 2 moles, therefore 2 plus 2, what I get, CV equal to 2R. Therefore, I can write the specific capacity at constant volume for 1 mole of a gas can be del U by del T. Let me cross multiply this, del mu equal to CV into del T. So this is the equation as to find out the internal energy for 1 mole of a gas. Suppose I want to find out the internal energy for mu molecule of gas, I have to multiply this equation by mu into mu. As a result, this is an expression for, general expression for changing internal energy while there is a rising temperature. It's a very, very important formula. As a matter of illustration, here I have given a graphical representation. The initial state of a gas is represented by P0, V0 and T1. And the final state of the system is represented by 2P0, 2V0 and T2. I have made equation of this ideal gas equation. Let me apply this ideal gas equation for the first state. It goes to be P0, V0, T1. P0, V0, T1. When I apply this ideal gas equation for the second final state, I can write 2P0, 2V0 by T2. So after simple manipulation, I can show that T2 equal to 4 into T1. So the formula has to find out this change in internal energy is del U equal to mu into CV into delta T. So let us assume that mu is the number of moles of a gas. Well, in considering the gas is of a monoatomic gas, I have to make a substitution for 3 by 2 into R. Suppose the given problem have diatomic gas, I have to substitute 5 by 2 into R. Change in temperature, initially the temperature is T1, final temperature is T2. Therefore, the change in temperature is written as T2 minus T1. Therefore, the change in internal energy is given by mu into 3 by 2 into R, 4 T1 minus T1. So, once you know the data, you can find out the change in internal energy for a monoatomic gas, or a diatomic gas, or a polyatomic gas using this relation.
Okay, wow. So we have defined a quantity which is called a molar specific capacity at constant volume. So what is the definition for molar specific capacity at constant volume? The amount of heat energy required to rise 1 mole of a gas through 1 Kelvin at constant volume. That is what is the definition for molar specific capacity at constant volume. Suppose the same thing has been done at constant pressure, then the quantity is called as molar specific capacity at constant pressure. Then what should be the definition for the specific capacity at constant pressure? It is represented by Cp. It is the amount of heat energy required to rise the temperature of 1 mole of a gas through 1 K at constant pressure. So the amount of heat energy Q equal to mu into Cp into delta T. From first law of thermodynamics, we know that Q equal to del U plus W. So in the place of this Q, I can make a substitution for mu into Cp into delta T. I know this change in internal energy in terms of specific capacity at constant volume as mu into Cv into delta T. I know from this the amount of work done can be written as W equal to P into del V. From gas equation, I can say that P del V equal to mu into R into delta T. Therefore, mu into Cp delta T equal to mu into Cv into delta T. In the place of P del V, I have made a substitution of mu into R into delta T. After cancelling the common factors, I can write Cp equal to Cv plus R. So it can be modified as Cp minus Cv equal to R, which is called as Mayer's relation. I have already shown this Cv equal to F by 2 into R. So I will substitute in Cv equal to F by 2 R in the place of Cp minus Cv equal to R turn to be Cp minus F by 2 into R, that is equal to R. After making cancellation, after making some adjustment, I can have the Cp equal to F by 2 plus 1 into R. So Cp can be found using this weighted average. So the formula is mu 1 into Cp 1. What is mu 1 as? Number of moles of this monoatomic gas. Cp 1 is the specific capacity at constant molar specific capacity at constant pressure of this monoatomic gas. Mu 2, number of moles of this diatomic gas. Cp 2, the molar specific capacity at constant for diatomic gas. So Cp 1 can be given as Cv1 plus R, which can be given as 5 by 2 R, that is for monoatomic gas. Cp2, Cv2 plus R, that is equal to 7 by 2 R. On making substitution, I get Cp equal to 3 into R. This is the way we have to determine this Cp. Next, we are going to talk about the ratio of the specific capacity at constant pressure to the molar specific capacity at constant volume. It has been said to be an adiabatic exponent, which is given by gamma. I have already shown you the expression for Cv as F by 2 into R and the expression for Cp as F by 2 R plus 1 into R. On dividing this, the adiabatic exponent goes to be gamma equal to 1 plus 2 by F, where gamma is called as the adiabatic component, F is called as the number of degrees of freedom. So let us come back to this Mayer's relation, Cp minus Cv equal to R. When we divide the whole equation by Cv, what I get is Cp minus Cv minus 1 equal to R into Cv. So after adjusting these things, so I can realize this, recognize the Cp by Cv as gamma. As a result, gamma minus 1 equal to R by Cv. Cv can be written as Cv equal to R by gamma minus 1. The change in internal energy can be written as mu into Cv into del T. So it's a very familiar relation. Once you know the change in temperature, you can find out this change in internal energy. The expression can be changed using this Cv equal to R by gamma minus 1. Therefore, the expression for change in internal energy goes to be mu into R by gamma minus 1 into delta T. So this equation also can be used to solve this problem involving change in internal energy with respect to change in temperature. So if you are provided with the change in volume as to find out the change in internal energy, this R into delta T can be changed into P into del V. The resulting equation gives you del U equal to mu into P into del V by gamma minus 1. Now I want to compare how much is the change in internal energy while here gas is heated at constant pressure as well as it is being heated at constant volume. Del UV equal to mu into Cv into del T. So this is an expression for the change in internal energy while the same gas is heated at constant volume. So our problem is we need to find out the ratio of the change in internal energy while this gas is heated at constant pressure to the change in internal energy while the same gas is heated at constant volume. So let me divide equation 1 by equation 2. What I get is Cp minus R by Cv. So instead of R, I can substitute Cp minus Cv. As a result, the equation becomes Cp minus Cp plus Cv by Cv. Cp gets cancelled with Cp. Therefore, I have the relation as del Up by del Uv as 1. So in this lecture, I have presented some basic concept of thermodynamics as to make you enjoy in learning this thermodynamics. I hope that you will enjoy this. Thank you.